Peyton Place, released in 1957. It's directed by Mark Rodson, and it's got an ensemble cast headed by Lana Turner, who plays Constance McKenzie. Russ Tamblyn is Norman Page, a friend of Alison McKenzie, who's played by Diane Vasey. Rodney Harrington is played by Barry Coe. Selena Field is played by Hope Large. Lucas Cross is a character that Arthur Canada plays. Terry Moore plays Betty, Rodney's girlfriend. And Mr. Rossi is played by Lee Phillips. He's the new teacher in town with new ideas. He sort of jumps into the principal's job ahead of a long-standing teacher who's been waiting for promotion for years. Peyton Place became a soap opera, a drama serial on TV, and the film is much like that. It's a small town in middle America. There are two sides of the town. There's the rich side and the less salubrious side of the track. And each side would prefer to stay on their particular side, apart from one or two who like to tread across and see what's happening on the other side. It's turning to the rich side of the track. Characters there, Turner playing Mackenzie, she's a very traditional, conservative, rigid mother who imposes her will heavily on Varsi, who plays Alison. This causes consternation, as Alison is now a young teenager. She's got interest in young boys, just like all the other girls, and she's finding it very difficult to experience some of the joys of adolescence. She's been itemized as a potential partner for Rodney Harrington, who really has no interest in her whatsoever, and prefers the girl from the other side of the tracks, Betty, who is more flirtatious, is more risque with her dress sense, and is much more attractive. We see religion imposing itself through the community, and this doesn't walk very hand in hand with the increased, shall we say, sexual openness within the teenage fraternity. And this causes considerable problems. The film tends to draw out the hypocrites, the liars, the murderers, and the sexual perverts, as one critic described it. And one particular part that develops is the relationship between Lucas Cross, played by Kennedy, and his stepdaughter, played by Hope Lange. And this leads to a situation latterly into the film where it's perceived that Cross actually rapes Selena, and this leads in the final part of the movie to problems in terms of evidence given at a trial following the Cross returns from the war and seeks out Selena. The wife stroke mother has passed on, and he arrives back and assumes that he can restart the abuse, and she fights back and inadvertently kills him, which leads to the court case. This is at the end of the movie, and so we notice that the movie from time to time throws up these sort of events to keep one sort of interested. They're always extreme and they're always controversial, and the TV series was very much like this. And I do remember a very young Mia Farrow starring in the TV series, and I confess that I was a viewer, although my mother and my sister were really keen on it because it happened in the 60s. So in conclusion, this film is set in and around the Second World War. Starts off in 1941. We go into wartime. Harrington, Rodney Harrington, dies in the war. It's a little bit of a film that's all over the place, really. It's sort of supposed to sort of bring out the hypocrisy of middle town America, and I suppose to some extent it achieves that. In terms of how it was received, well, it was subject to a huge amount of Oscar nominations. Didn't win any, but Turner was nominated for Best Actress. The producer, Jerry Wall, got the Best Picture nomination. Kennedy was on, and Russ Tamblyn, Best Actor supporting roles. And the Best Actress supporting roles, Hope Lange and Diane Varsey. Robson got a director nomination, and there were other nominations for screenplay and cinematography. It also did pretty well at the Golden Globes, with Varsey actually winning the Most Promising Newcomer award. I hardly see it as an Oscar contender, to be perfectly honest, but it did very well at the box office, turning in $25 million. It's one of those attractive sort of drama with events that tend to shock and awe us. So there we are. That's Peyton Place, 1957. Give it a look over.
Peyton Place. The town everyone's talking about. All the people of Peyton Place, with all their joys and sorrows, passions and compassions, are on the screen at last.
I'm going to tell you a hard truth about yourself. It isn't sex you're afraid of. You can say yes or no to that. It's love. That's what you can't handle.
There's a place I know that I'd like to show you that no one knows about. Not even you. It's my secret place.
I knew every spot within 3 miles of Peyton Place. I never knew this place was here.
I don't think anybody does but me. Maybe God. Now you.
What'd you whistle for?
Just saw a young fella and a girl swimming without a stitch on.
Where?
They got out the water and ran into the woods.
Naked?
Naked?
You really want to kiss me, don't you?
Why do I?
Tell me how much.
Video.
Tell me.
Selina. You've got to call the state police.
No. No, I can't.
You've got to.
Here is Constance McKenzie, as played by Lana Turner. Selina Cross, played by Hope Lange. Michael Rossi, played by Lee Phillips. Doc Swain, played by Lloyd Nolan. Allison McKenzie, played by the most amazing star discovery of the year, Diane Varsey. Lucas Cross, played by Arthur Kennedy. Norman Page, played by Russ Tamblyn. Betty Anderson, played by Terry Moore. With Barry Coe as Rodney, David Nelson as Ted Carter, Betty Field as Nellie, Mildred Dunnock as Mrs. Thornton, Leon Ames as Harrington.